And to your right, on the other side of the cruise ship terminal, a very impressive U.S. warship and ship. I'm about to point out to you this morning is one of four Iowa-class battleships, which were, in fact, the largest battleships ever built, with the exception of two, constructed by the Japanese during the Second World War. First of the Iowa-class ships built was BB-61, which was the USS Iowa. BB-62 was USS New Jersey. BB-63, USS Missouri. The battleship we're looking at to our right, the fourth and last class constructed to your right, is BB-64, which is the battleship USS Wisconsin. The ship was built in the Philadelphia Naval Shipyard and commissioned on the 16th of April, 1944. All four of the Iowa-class ships saw action during the Second World War, including the Wisconsin, that won five battle stars for engagements against the Japanese. And they were large and very expensive ships to operate. When the war was over, the Iowa-class ships were decommissioned. Later recommissioned during the Korean War, and they were decommissioned. The battleship New Jersey was activated a very brief period of time during the Vietnam War, but shortly after that decommissioned. It wasn't until the Reagan administration and the tremendous buildup of the U.S. Armed Services that the Iowa-class ships were once again brought back into operation. Wisconsin was the last of the four to go back into service. The Navy recommissioning the ship in 1986, but not before they spent $470 million to activate the ship. A lot of the money went to modernize the Wisconsin. After all, this is a World War II era battleship. A lot of the money went for new weapon systems, but they left aboard most of the ship's original weaponry, adding to the Wisconsin the ability of launching guided missiles. You would find a pie on this ship's superstructure, 8 armor-plated boxes, 4 on the side of the ship. The 8 boxes combined can contain 32 Tomahawk cruise missiles. Tomahawk is the most accurate long-range missile in the U.S. arsenal. It may be tipped with a tactical nuclear warhead with a range of 900 miles, conventionally armed with a range of 700 miles. By the way, that missile has pinpoint accuracy. The ship also was outfitted with 16 canisters designed to carry 16 of our Navy's anti-ship missiles called Harpoon. Harpoon is the most versatile missile system in the United States Navy. The weapon is deployed aboard most of the Navy's surface ships and can be launched from their submarines as well as from some of the Navy's aircraft. No matter what platform it is launched from, Harpoon becomes a low-flying C-screen missile when it is designed to fly only 15 to 20 feet above the surface of the water. That makes it almost impossible for an enemy ship to detect the radar until it's right upon them. For that reason, Harpoon has a better than 95% kill rate. The missile has a range of 80 nautical miles, delivering to its target high explosive warhead with armor-piercing capability. This ship also was outfitted with 4 Vulcan Phalanx close-in weapons. We'll tell you more about Vulcan Phalanx and some of the ships in the base later today. As you may have guessed, what the United States Navy left on board the